I'm going to do a short demo, 19x, of two target acquisitions, and then I'm going to do a reload, okay? Mind you, I have sensory damage in both hands. I have a disability through the VA because of it, 70%, 40%, right? Sometimes I can't feel the pistol, sometimes I can't feel the mag, but sometimes when I reload, it looks perfect. So we're going to continue to work on it. What it looks like. There's another one. So if I'm engaging a target, when you're grabbing the side of the pistol, these thumbs press the side of that frame just as much as the rest of your hand grips. These thumbs press the side of the frame. That will give you the best recoil, right? So a lot of people say that recoil is found and managed from the elbow forward, right? Because if my elbows are locked, I'm now taking it in the back and the shoulders. If my elbows are just barely unlocked and poking out, like that, right? You're able to take that recoil right here in the front, okay? But strong hands equals strong grip. If you push to the side of your frame right here, you're going to manage that a lot more. When I did sheepdog response course, they had people go through and do rapid fire, and he had a cadence. Boom, 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 boom. We would try to match that cadence. I'm not trying to toot horns, but when it came down to me, he continued to get faster until he said, burn him, see how fast you can go. I did 10 rounds as fast as I could squeeze that trigger, and it all stayed within the same box at 7 yards. So your recoil management is all in your grip and your stance, right? Make sure your elbows are not locked, right? I have them just, it's almost like a relaxed posture, right? Thumbs pressed to the side. This hand is gripping this hand just as much as this hand is gripping the pistol. Okay?